bit that I did not do in the video one. Okay, so I actually already did the video once, but because of the poor lighting, I am doing it again. Just there will be not much explanation. If you'll see these all lines are parallel to each other, and then you connect them. And you can shade this part. I'm kind of assuming that light is falling in this direction. So the top and this part are white, and the rest of the part is a little darker. Or you can slightly shade here also. It all depends upon your assumption from which direction the light is falling. These are all pretty much similar. Like I said before in the other video, the ones with straight lines are simple. Only the ones with the little, you know, curves like maybe P, O are little trickier. But those are also not too difficult. This is I. Okay. Yeah, even this is the curve. This is the easiest one. this one is like this. So I'm drawing a little faster because, you know, the videos are going too long. Maybe a little like this here. Yeah. Now this one. So when you are drawing, draw them neat. This is the video that will show you only the technique, okay? I'm not doing it super neat or the lines might not be super straight. Some other time I'll make a video on different types of shading and all. This I'm just, you know, scribbling. Q and O are pretty much similar. I'm using a pen now because even though I tried to make the video in the daylight, I was not able to make it because of the weekend and kids and all. So I again had to do it in the night. Then I felt the pen, using pen would better, the visibility will be better. Like I said, this is part of project that my students are doing. This is all very interesting. It's not only, you know, art, it has a lot of, you know, science and math going on, a lot of imagination going on